Hi guys, this is TGM. Today I'm gonna show you some useful and commonly unknown commands and tricks with WorldEdit in Minecraft. This video is not about the basics of WorldEdit. You can like look that up. It's more about like nifty little tricks and basically what you can get out of Minecraft when you know the right commands. Let me get a screenshot. Let me get out of the. It's actually a pretty good screenshot. This person is better to show this off. So, first of all, I want to start. When you use WorldEdit normally, like, you know, /1 probably. Like this. You get this pickaxe. You can select, like, the cuboid. Like this. Telling you positions and how much blocks it has selected and all that stuff. But actually there are other cool methods to select something. I made like 1/4 of an arch, and first I selected it like you normally would, but let's try this differently. So you can also, without having this wand, select the thing just by flying at the position where you are, where you want to start your selection, and do /POS 1 for the first position. And actually it's gonna select this block right here. Like, because I was standing in this block, selecting the block my feet are in. And then I could select this block down here. Would be quite easier to use this wand, but you can also just like look at it and do /HPOS the second, and position already set because I used the thing on it, but whatever. Now we have this selected, and there's one other trick. Like, people really like to use the wand, so I'm just gonna show you another trick. Like, when you have something in the air and you really want to use your wand, try to do /up1, and you will see you go one block up. It can be like a different amount if you like, but basically it's easier when you just fly where you want to be, one block up. You get this nifty little glass block, and then yeah, you can select it with your wand again. So let's make this 1/4 of an arch, one complete arch with the backside and everything. Whenever it's selected, easy way, I could do use copy first and then rotate like 180, and then I could paste it. But now you see it's a bit of a problem because I don't have the other stuff. There's also another command, it's called flip. But first, let's try with undo. Let's try like a bigger selection, just like a bit random one. Like, I hover here and I select that block down there. Bit of a random selection, having quite some air blocks in here. When I rotate that again and then paste it again, you will see there's stuff missing because the air blocks were pasted in with it. There's a nifty little trick in that to be able to paste this without having the air blocks pasted, and that's basically done by just paste -a, and you see the air blocks are not pasted in here, although I gotta say I got rid of this thing down here, so making a good selection is always a good idea. Let's make a good selection. And now let's get the other part. And when I stay here, copy it. And then flip it. Yeah, thing you normally should know. The mirror is like directly rectangular to the direction you're facing. Like when I look in this direction, the actual mirror where this thing will be mirrored is in this line here. So yeah, I'm facing this direction to make this my mirror, kinda. And when I do that, and I paste it again, you will see, even with paste minus A, it will fuck up. This is because it's taking the middle out of my copy and then trying to match my position where it was, and then it's trying to paste it in, and everything fucks up. And I don't know why they did that, but there's an easy fix for that as well. It's a flag. I need to copy it again though. And that would be minus P. So it's focused on me, and if I paste it now, it's neatly arranged, you see? Perfect. Nothing could be done better. Yeah, we could select this again. Like this, and then probably down here. Although I have to get rid of this to get the bottom part with. Let's copy this. And oh yeah, first. And make sure you look in the right direction. You can also put the direction in there, but looking it's way easier. And paste. There you go. Finished arch. Probably not fix that little bit there. Yeah, that's the first thing I want to show you. Like these flags, minus A for paste, and also minus P for flip. Pretty useful stuff. Okay. When you use flip before, you probably have also used / / move. That's also a cool thing when you want to move whole things. I could just show you. Move one moves it one block over. The stuff was still selected, so that only the selection got moved. Pretty useful command. Most people don't know. Okay, let's talk about special blocks you probably see around here, and how to get knowledge about them. So first, I want to show you when I hover above a block, you see there's not only the name, but there's also the ID with a hashtag, and then sometimes it has this little dash. These numbers after the dash, this is metadata, so-called metadata. That's pretty interesting stuff when you want to get cool blocks, like over here. Complete bark oak block, I would call it. What's it actually called? We can find that out. That's another cool trick. Oh yeah, first tell you, how did I get that? That's pretty easy. You just press F3 and H. And when you've done that, see, it's gone. And when I do it again, it's back there again. Yeah, so getting IDs easily. There's also another thing that's built into, /L. Lists you everything you look for that has, for example, gold in the name, and there get all the IDs of everything that has gold in its name. Pretty useful as well. Now how to get, like, we talked about getting data values out of blocks in your inventory, or information about blocks you know the name of. Let's get blocks that are in the actual world. I'm just gonna take a tool and I'm gonna make it my info tool. //info does that, and I can click on every block and it's gonna tell me the position. Then the yellow number is the ID. Then comes the name in the edged bracket thingies. That's the meter dot again, and the 04 thing. I'm not quite sure what that is. Maybe someone could tell me in the comments if they found out. I never used it though. Like sometimes 44. Maybe it has something to do with a cycle. Because there's another tool. Let's take a different tool. The cycler. That's pretty useful. Because what that does, it cycles through the metadata of a block. You see, this block is actually from a giant mat room, and I can switch through all the texture types by changing the metadata. And you see, every time I use this, I use my cycler, the number goes up till it eventually comes back down to zero, depending on how much cycles are there. Oh, there we go. So there's one problem with the cycler though, because it's like pre-numbered. How do you explain that? The numbers that for the cycle are put in beforehand, so if something is added later, it's probably not in the cycle, so I don't like that tool, go away. Okay, let's switch some other thingies. This is oh wait, I still wanted to switch stuff. This is actually a red one, this is a brown one, this is a chest you can cycle around, and now look at this one. Wow, you see actually all the different colors of wood are yeah, not only wood but also trunks and leaves and everything. It's actually metadata on the block, so the ID stays the same. It's all 17, right? Yeah, it's all 17. And yeah, with what that you can get some extra block you might not be able to get else. For example, this one, ID 17 and metadata 12. So let's get a random dirt block. Could just pick one up, but whatever. Select this one and set it to 1712. You see? Wow. It's the block, the lock 17 with metadata 12, all-sided block. Pretty cool when you want to make like a god tree or something. It's for all of the types of wood. There's some other cool blocks we see in a second, but we are at trees right now, so let's talk about leaves. If you wanted to make like leaves with world edit, I'm gonna make a tool for that, and this tool is gonna be 18 CID for leaves, and let's make it 1. But the metadata just showed us here 8, there 0, that there's a difference, and you see the difference by this stuff despawning and this stuff not despawning. So when you have problems with pasting leaves and they start to despawn, you want to prevent that. Just put in a different metadata value, and takes a bit of time to find out which are the good ones, but I think it was like 4, 5, 6, and 7 were the good ones, right? Or maybe it switched around. No, I think 4, 5, 6, and 7 are the good ones that don't despawn. Like 4 would be the normal ones, then 5 would be the birch ones. Okay, I don't know. Doesn't really matter. You can find it out by yourself with a little bit of wordletter. Okay, let's go on with blocks. Pretty cool blocks. We have number 36 right here. That's invisible. Actually, it's a moving piston piece. But yeah, you can walk through it. It's a pretty cool block just to hold of water, for example, or you could put on floating. Let me do this. A floating trapdoor. Well, what normally wouldn't be possible if you wouldn't have a block underneath it. So that's a cool thing to have. Then we have the not moving piston head piece, all sided piston head. When you actually click it, you get a piston like middle mouse button. 3314 makes a cool block for, I would say, crates and like boxes and such, but also I use it on the roof of this little thing where we come later to. Yeah, this double half slab with outside top of the stone half slab. 338, also pretty cool thing you can get with what it. All-sided sandstone top block. It's all default in Minecraft, like, I didn't change anything except for my texture pad, maybe, which you already saw, but it's not really much changed. None of these blocks are changed, though. Yeah, 339. Probably most of you know sponge. 19. Everlasting furnace, pretty useful for decorating. Like, it will burn even though there's nothing in it, except when you update the block, like when you put something in, it will probably realize I don't have anything with what I could burn this, so it would probably stop then. But for decoration purposes, pretty nice. And then 9 and 11, I would say probably some of you people know that already. That's unupdated water, like not flowing, and unupdated lava also not flowing. So block updates. These two blocks aren't updated. What would happen if we update them? Let's talk about updates of block updates, because it's pretty useful. You can make cool stuff when you know stuff about block updates. For example, I put in here like a redstone block. This redstone block is just an example. It's basically any block you place in Minecraft, like this dirt block. But when you place a block, all the sides, all the lamps symbolized by these lamps, all these blocks are gonna be updated. The dark ones are not gonna be updated. So you can make like a crisscross pattern of blocks that don't update each other when they are placed, and it's pretty useful. You could make like a checkerboard style thing out of unupdated water, something like that. Yeah, some cool feature I came up with, a combination of the invisible one, 36, and not updated blocks would be this pattern. You see floating trapdoors with glowstone behind. Makes a pretty cool ceiling, if you ask me. It's pretty easy to make if you know how, because yeah, all you need to know is how to make blocks not update and how to make a block number 36, so actually trapdoors can be on it. I'm going to show you this real quick. We have here already in these lower parts is already number, you see it on the line here, maybe number 36 invisible in there. And yeah, let's take this block and this block, and I also need a trapdoor to know what trapdoor I'm gonna make it. Let's get the info. It's 96.8, and yeah, let's select this actually again, and now we do // replace, correct, yeah, grass, and 968, and we see, yay, we got trapdoors, which worked fine. And now we select this one, and this one, and do the other row. Replace stone. And yay. Okay, one updated. But whatever. You could fix that. You basically get the point. Because of the not direct connected blocks, they not update each other when they are placed, and so you can make this pattern which eventually ends up like this ceiling. Okay, let's go on. And here's a pretty neat trick with vines. When you put vines down and don't give them metadata, then actually 106 is fine. Yeah, then you don't see them, but you can still walk them up. But they automatically update because vines grow, and then it's all kind of lost and it's not invisible anymore. But if you could do like /stop/lag on your server hub, and you wanted to have like this secret ladder, you could use this pretty cool thing. And the other one didn't work. There's nothing. Okay, other cool thing: invisible walkway. Invisible blocks where you can actually stand on this time, and as you might see, if I punch them away, it's chests. Kind of a visual glitch. So yeah, when you place chests next to each other, you can do this real quick. Let's set it to chests. They are invisible, except like the last row or last corner bit, and yeah, but you could neatly hide that in like a mountain or something, so it has definitely practical use, and pretty cool having an invisible block that can block players. Okay, let's go to the next thing. Patterns, like check patterns, for example this one. Pre-made this one, pretty easy thing where you can put everything, like every pattern on everything you see, real quick, without using like /generate or whatever with math functions. Just like select it, doesn't really matter where you stand, then copy. Like where you stand when you copy it, doesn't really matter. And now you can select like the area you want to transform, for example. I think I need to be, no, should be fine. Position 2. And you can set it to your clipboard. So, // replace. If I don't put anything, it's gonna replace everything except there with it. And then clipboard. And wow, look at that. Easy patterns. That's the way to go with World Edit. And what I really like is like these circular textures when you have like a ball or sphere with these diagonal patterns. Having these circles going on is a really cool feature if you ask me. Okay, yeah, let's go to the next thing. Something probably most of you don't know. You can do skulls with World Edit. Let's use our info tool again, // info on tool, if you don't remember. And yeah, you see, hat 144, metadata 1. So, how do we do this? I'm selecting this block I placed in beforehand, and set this block just to skull. And we see the sitting skull has metadata 1. And then we do a vertical line and a case sensitive username. And you see, there's my head again. 3 times my head. Yay! You can do that with pretty much any user. For example, Notch, there you go, notch set. With what I did, really easy. Okay, next thing, you will not believe it, you can actually do spawners with world edit, like no joke. Pre-made like a creeper spawner, you can't fight that. Also, you see kittens spawn around, ocelot spawner. ID 52, and yeah, how does this work? Let's make this block a spawner. Slash slash set spawner, and we do a vertical line again, and for example with a boss, and we see, yay, we got a with a boss spawner. You have to keep in mind though that actually the spawning still is restricted by maybe materials and stuff like that, so animals only spawn on grass and dirt, I think, and like creeper would spawn anywhere. See, the ocelot spawner works. Could this spawner make, for example, a giant spawner? Wow, there you go, wither and giant spawner. Never saw that in default Minecraft before, did you? Pretty cool stuff. Okay, we kind of reached the end. I still got some cool stuff though. For example, for administration stuff, I don't like the bar. Let's undo the last two. Oh, yeah, there where the bar is gone. Spawners, and now other cool commands. You see, like these entities. Like someone spammed them on server or whatever. Easy fix with world edit. You just do slash remove. And I certainly mistyped because type and then radius. Get this card. 50. There we go. All gone. Same as fire. Someone set something on fire. Extinguish, radius, done, fire is gone. Also, lava pools, water pools, if there's no water layer below, you still get these evil bugs. In creative you can jump right in, slash, fix, lava, 5. Oh, wait, missed space, no. Did I do wrong? Oh, maybe one fix lava 5? Okay, I have no idea. Fix lava? Didn't I do that? Didn't I do exactly that? Fix lava... Oh, okay, so it's actually one slash and together. Also, when you fucked up with water, and you don't really want it anymore, you can drain liquids. Bam! Whole water pool is gone. Just like drain radius. Really helpful. Yeah. And let's go back to this awesome sphere. There's also some cool stuff about that. There's fill. And you cannot fill like only with water, you can fill with basically anything. So let's do fill R, recursive, whatever, it just means that if there's a hangover, it's still, it's like, if there's no connection to the sun, it still fills it up. And let's do dirt, and how deep would be, no, first range, so maybe 50? There we go. All filled up with dirt. Maybe we could do it a bit higher even. Yeah, there we go. All filled up with dirt. And now the real magic. This thing is now filled, but we can empty it without like draining it, because you can't drain blocks really. Let's select this again. Position 1. Position 2. And slash slash hollow. Yeah, for real. Hollow is a command that works. Look at it, it's gone. Awesome. About some other thing, when you like inside something, want to get out. You probably know that command, through. Gets you through stuff. Slash unstuck, when you stuck yourself in a ball you made with a tool, something like that. Yeah. One or two last things when we select this again. Oh, we have the ball. Why don't we take the ball? Let's replace it with dirt. And let's make it look natural, kind of. There's slash slash naturalize. Like this. And wow, look at it. I selected the dirt. Oh, I selected the dirt and made it look kinda natural. And what you also can do is make it green with bone meal, but also we could just like put a layer of I don't know, more grass on it. Maybe we want four layers deep of dirt and not just three, so there's slash slash overlay, right, and grass. Look at it, more grass on top. Or they can also be used like to put like the real tall grass on huge areas without you having to run around with bone meal. And yeah, it's another cool thing when you want to have trees quickly. Make a tree tool. Actually starts with tool, I think. Tree, tool, and then the kind. Let's just make a big one. And you have to be like, it won't work when you're too far away, but when you see the edge going on, you can right click it, and there you go. Not really big though. Let's test another time. Ah, okay, that's a better one. Yeah, finally, one last thing. You can set biomes, and you can get the biome list. If you have like colors of grass you don't like, biome lists I want. There we go. Let's make this a desert. Was it biome set, right? Or set biome? Set biome? Nope. Slash slash set biome, right. And desert. There we go. Biome has been changed. One thing. You need to unload that area. So when I go away now, unload it, and I come back now. You see, it's like this brownish type you get when you have trees in a desert, and when you look in a tree, it also tells you desert. Yeah, that's it. Hope you learned some stuff. Hope you can use World Edit now with a deeper understanding, and yeah, generally. Know what your tool or what your tools in this particular case, what that it really does. Yeah. See you next time maybe, and bye.